Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with an 11th generation server from HPE. It's called the HPE ProLiant DL360, just a new generation. It's been completely overhauled to support dual fourth generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, codenamed Sapphire Rapids. Compared to the third generation CPUs with up to 40 cores, these fourth gen processors provide a significant increase in core counts at up to 60 cores each. It also supports up to 8 terabytes of memory and 2 single-wide GPUs to accelerate graphics-intensive workloads. Let's take a look. This is a highly adaptable platform that can be used to support a number of workloads, including virtual desktop infrastructure, or VDI, electronic design automation, or EDA, and computer-assisted design, or CAD, applications. Given the flexibility, it's also a shoe-in for general business workloads with a 1U density-optimized configuration. That right there sounds like some good marketing lingo. In a nutshell, it means it can accommodate a lot of traffic while processing large amounts of data without turning into a pile of molten slag from electric and thermal loads. I did embellish that a bit, but I think that's fairly accurate. Storage is flexible with options for 8 to 10 2.5-inch SFF, another with 4 3.5-inch LFF drive bays, and a new configuration supporting up to 20 EDSFF E3 NVMe SSD options, which are those smaller but longer and more compact solid-state drive formats. Two internal NVMe M.2 drives are also supported, either with an internal module or externally accessible from the rear of the system as in hot swap option. We'll get to that in a minute. Supported drive formats for the 3.5-inch option include SATA and SAS HDDs or SSDs only. No NVMe. For the 2.5-inch chassis, users have a choice of SATA, SAS, or NVMe U.3 drive formats supported by a tri-mode backplane. Lastly, the EDSFF drives are all NVMe SSDs. The front of the system will accept a newly designed bezel, but not sure if aesthetically it is an improvement. That's for you to decide. If you're interested in purchasing the HPE ProLiant DL360 Gen11 server, then IT Creations has a deal for you. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that's listed on itcreations.com or one that you can configure using our configurator that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video and save at itcreations.com. The configurations for the 2.5-inch and 3.5-inch chassis are slightly different, but both have a small control panel on the right server ear. That panel has a power on button, health LED, NIC status LED, and a unit identification button with integrated LED. Both platforms can be outfitted with an optical drive, display port, and a USB 2.0 port, which are all optional. By the way, ours has an 8-bay configuration and none of that optional hardware I just mentioned. A USB 3.2 port and integrated lights out port are standard equipment. A small panel on the left of those can support the optional System Insight Display module, or SID module. On the 2.5-inch bay chassis, that media panel with the optional optical device, USB, and iDRAC ports can be replaced with an optional 2 drive bay drive cage, bringing that 8-bay chassis up to 10 2.5-inch drives total. The System Insight Display panel provides additional information for troubleshooting without removing the cover panel. It offers information on power, PCI risers, temperature, processors, memory, and fans, but is only available in the 2.5-inch chassis configuration. The back panel shows a row of 3 PCI slots on top, then dual redundant 1+1 power supply units on the right. There are options for PSUs depending on how the system is configured. Below the PSUs and PCI slots, there are 2 OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slots. Between the OCP card slots, the unit ID LED, dual USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, an ILO management port, and a serial port beside that, with VGA port wedged in between the OCP slot and PSUs. Taking some design cues from an unnamed competitor, this system has the option to install a hot plug NS204i.U boot device in the back. It features dual M.2 drives that offer a hardware RAID 1 to support the OS. It fits in a x16 PCI 5.0 slot or can be cabled to a port on the system board and requires no PCI slot. We don't have that, unfortunately. That dedicated management port provides access to the integrated lights out standard with intelligent provisioning. ILO Advanced and HPE OneView are optional, offering more tools to manage the system. At this point, HPE has moved on from ILO 5.0 to ILO 6.0. ILO 6.0 delivers the same tools it always did: ongoing management, service alerting, plus add chassis and remote management of the system to quickly troubleshoot and resolve problems and allocate resources. I'm going to assume some improvements were made or there were compatibility issues with the fourth gen CPUs and chipset necessitating an upgrade. The 11th generation servers also offer enhanced security with further modifications to the silicone root of trust, ensuring firmware updates are matched to the installed Intel CPU with an application-specific integrated circuit, or ASIC. There is more to these abstract management features, but let's get back to the hardware. Inside the case, you can see the dual CPU sockets for the 4th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. Each socket supports 16 memory modules for a total of 32 active memory module slots with both processors installed. The CPUs on the 20EDSFF chassis can be outfitted with a performance fan kit and a closed-loop liquid cooling heatsink. We don't have that configuration, and it won't be available until the third quarter of this year. The 4th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors support 8 to 60 physical cores, depending on your choice, and you can double that for a virtual thread count supported by Intel's hyper-threading technology. With two 60-core processors installed, that's up to 120 physical cores. You only get up to 32 cores with gold or 20 with silver, each socket. Looks like bronze is making another appearance too. I thought the 3rd generation scalable processors did away with that one. With 8-channel memory architecture and 16 slots per CPU, there's the potential for 2 DIMMs per channel. Using 256 gigabyte memory modules in all 32 memory module slots, the system can support up to 8 terabytes of DDR5 3DS registered memory modules operating at speeds of up to 4,400 megatransfers per second. The specs don't even mention Intel Optane memory. Top speed is achieved with 1 DIMM per channel at up to 4,800 megatransfers per second. If you do install those 256 gigabyte memory modules, then high-speed networking in excess of 100 gigs or more for PCIe or OCP cannot be selected. With 256 gigabyte memory modules, the high-performance fan kit with 7 performance fans is required instead of the standard 5 fan configuration. With a performance fan kit, you get 2 fans for redundancy. Another thing to keep in mind is that while DDR5 memory is faster than DDR4, apparently the boot time is longer because initialization of DDR5 takes a bit longer. Software RAID controllers include the embedded virtual RAID on CPU, or VROC, with 10 accessible ports. Also a VROC Enterprise Hybrid Software RAID solution for SSDs and an HBA version for Direct Connect drives. There are 4x8 PCI 5.0 connectors per socket on the backplane for support of up to 8 direct attached x4 NVMe bays, but only on the SFF model. No NVMe on the LFF chassis. Several performance Gen 11 RAID controllers are supported too, just not for the EDSFF platform. There are 2 risers, a standard primary butterfly riser with 2 PCI 5.0x16 slots, one full height, half length, and the other a low profile slot. Those are slots 1 and 2. With a second processor installed, a secondary riser is available with either a full height or low profile x16 slot. That would be slot 3. The secondary riser will take out the low profile slot in the primary riser, as only 2 full height slots are supported. GPUs with a maximum wattage of 75 watts are supported, and that includes the Tesla T4 and the Ampere architecture-based NVIDIA A2 GPUs. NVIDIA's A2 16GB PCIe GPU offers low power with a 40 to 60 watt power draw and high performance capabilities. It's designed for AI, AI inference, 5G edge computing, and industrial applications. Those 2 OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slots provide more options for network communications without using those limited PCI slots. The system is only 1U, so if you want the utility of those GPUs, then those OCP card slots will provide an attractive alternative. With OCP 3.0, you can also just slide the card in from the back of the system without having to remove the cover panel, a great feature for upgrade and replacement. HPE's ProLiant DL360 Gen 11 is a highly flexible platform that can be used to support a number of business-critical applications like general compute, database management, content delivery, edge acceleration, and intelligent video analytics. And that's just a few of the capabilities of this system, as configuration is the key. Well, configuration and choosing the right processor to support your application. If you are interested in the HPE DL360 Gen 11 server, then check out itcreations.com. We have this system in stock and can configure it to your specifications. Need something else? We carry a range of HPE servers and HP workstations, or if you need a critical part, itcreations.com. If you have any questions on this platform or any other, post them in the comments section below. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.